Hey guys, my name is Travis, and before we get into this video, I just want to make sure that everybody knows, if you have not seen Captain America Civil War, do not watch this video. It's going to be chock full of spoilers having to do with Spider-Man in Captain America Civil War. I've seen so many things online in recent weeks with Batman v Superman, or Game of Thrones, or Civil War, where people are like, spoiler alert, and then they just go right into the spoilers and don't give a chance for the people reading it to stop reading it, and then they're already into spoilers. And then people get upset. So I just want to give this long-winded intro to let you know that there will be spoilers in this video. As a lot of you know, I am a huge Spider-Man fan. I even went as far as making a Scarlet Spider costume. I have action figures, statues, little plushies, the Buddy L Spider van. I even have this thing, which I don't know why anybody would have it. This knife, this Spider-Man knife that's less of a knife and more like a sword. This is like, this could hurt somebody very badly. I don't know why it exists, but I own it because it's Spider-Man. So you may be thinking, somebody who loves Spider-Man this much might be a little biased when it comes to a character on the big screen. But dare I say, I might be more critical than just your everyday Spider-Man fan, because this is a character that I know and love, and any interpretation of it that goes against the grain or that I don't agree with, I could be kind of harsh about that. I mean, I could. Tobey Maguire is Spider-Man. All right. Andrew Garfield is Spider-Man. Okay. Tom Holland is Spider-Man. This was the most perfect iteration of Spider-Man we've ever been given. And I do not say that lightly. Remember, I own a spider knife. First off, let's talk about the positives. Tom Holland has the definite look for a high school Peter Parker. He has the acting chops to be able to say things that he's not actually saying. The lines when he's talking to Tony about why he does it, and Tony's like, oh yeah, you're doing it for the little guy, right? And Tom, as Peter, he's like, oh, yeah, the little guy. But really, we all know that he's talking about Uncle Ben. But we don't need to know that because we already know that because of what he's saying. Just like when he was talking about that thing that happened to me. He mentioned it, I think, like twice, just very, very briefly. And it's the spider bite, we know. But he doesn't have to bring it up. Just touch, go, hit the ground running. Another great thing is that Peter Parker is swinging around New York already as Spider-Man. We don't have to have an origin story because we don't need an origin story. And it's the perfect excuse for Tony to find him because he already has his powers. And then he gives him a new Spider-Man suit. And then the first time we're seeing him in the new suit, it's the same time that Cap's team is seeing him for the first time. So it's like this whole, oh, what? Reveal, and it's amazing. I mean, I guess we saw him in the trailer before the movie came out, but still, it's really neat that characters are seeing this thing happen at the same time that we are seeing this thing happen. It's like a weird shared experience in the movie. And because Tony upgraded his suit, Peter feels indebted to Tony, and he wants to prove himself. He wants to show off, and he wants to make Tony proud, which is just such a level of humor because nobody's really done that in a Marvel movie. Nobody's ever like, oh yeah, I'm gonna make him proud. Even Scott, when he got the Ant-Man suit, he's like, oh, I guess I'll do the thing. But Peter's like, oh, I need to impress them. I need to be amazing. I need to be the amazing Spider-Man. That was too dumb of a joke. Spider-Man stole every single scene that he was in. And it was amazingly fantastic. I was laughing so hard during all of the parts that Spider-Man was in. You have a metal arm? I need to impress Mr. Stark. You have the right to remain silent. Oh, it was gold. This is the Peter Parker Spider-Man that we needed. This is what we've been waiting for. And I really hope that all the naysayers of the Spider-Man reboots will finally be able to see that this is the best iteration of Spider-Man that we've ever been given. And it's in a Marvel movie. He's part of the Marvel Universe. Imagine if Sony did this before, it would have been great, but he would have never had these interactions with these characters. So in a sense, it's kind of good that Sony kept tanking with Spider-Man, I guess, maybe? So that now he can be part of the team and part of the universe, and it's all a really big, bigger, extended sort of thing. And now onto the negatives of Spider-Man in this movie. Because there has to be negatives of Spider-Man in this movie, right? I just can't think of any. Oh, I do have a negative. He wasn't in the movie long enough. That's not what you were looking for. I'm sorry. I don't know of any negatives that, he was so great in this movie. I'm so excited for the new Spider-Man movie, Homecoming. Ah, I cannot wait. I'm like super jazzed right now and I want to go see this movie again really badly. Even Deadpool, I waited like 2 weeks before seeing it a second time. I want to see this movie again this weekend. There are some people that are calling Captain America Civil War their favorite superhero movie or the best superhero movie ever, which is high praise, and it's definitely in my top three. I feel like Deadpool is up there too. So, but what do you guys think? I'm really hoping that you've seen Captain America Civil War because you sat through this whole video. So in the comments down below, let me know your thoughts about Tom Holland as Spider-Man and if you're super excited for the new movie like you should be, and what you thought about Captain America Civil War and who else was amazing. Black Panther was brilliant. I loved the differences between, oh, these guys are making jokes and Black Panther's just like serious face the whole movie. He's like, I have a job to do, I need to kill this guy. I like how even though they weren't in the movie, Pepper and Bruce and Thor were all mentioned and brought up in conversation because that's normal. It's not like these characters would just forget about their friends just because the actors don't have contracts to be in this movie. I might do another video soon talking about other thoughts that I have about Civil War, but right now I just wanted to do a very Spider-Man centric video because it was great. I loved it. I loved Spider-Man in this movie. I loved it. As always, my name is Travis. Thank you for listening to what I have to say, and you will see me soon. Is this what you wanted to see? I mean, I guess I can't very well show off a mask in a video and not put it on, even though it's Ben Reilly clashing with Peter, I guess. But what are you gonna do?